Okay, today we are playing a game on Ilios. We are playing Roadhog for the majority of the game and a little bit of D.Va towards the end, and the average SR of this game was 2,418. Also, gentleman who sent this in, name Space Clam. One of the better names I've ever seen, honestly. In space, no one can hear you honk. So, anyway though, let's look at our team. We've got Roadhog, obviously, Genji, Winston, Lucio, Anna, and Reaper. So we've got a very King of the Hill team. We've got no Reinhardt, but that's not the end of the world because it's King of the Hill. Reinhardt is quite good on ruins though, because it is basically just a straight line. But it's not the end of the world. The concerning thing is that we don't have anything that's really good at killing Pharah. We have Anna, but she's not so good at killing Pharah anymore after they lowered her damage slightly. And nobody else can really kill her. So basically it's just us and Anna, but neither of our heroes are that good at killing Pharah. So, and this is ruins. Chance of them having a Pharah, pretty high. So that's, you know, that's going to be an issue. And they do have a Pharah as well, so it is in fact an issue. They also have a Widowmaker, but we have a Winston, so hopefully Winston can do something about that to make sure that the Widowmaker doesn't actually get anything done. So, we're coming up now on the right-hand side. We see that they have a Pharah. However, we are relieved to see that she doesn't have a Mercy tethered to her just yet, so. We see the Winston right here. He puts his bubble down right as we try to hook him. That really sucks. There, Roadhog hooks us. Oh, but he didn't quite kill us. Oh, we didn't quite kill him. Unfortunate, you know. Usually in the Roadhog versus Roadhog matchup, the Roadhog that hooks first is the one that dies, which seems counterintuitive to you, probably, but, like, let me explain why that happens, because the Roadhog that hooks first, you're gonna get, like, assuming both Roadhogs have their hooks off cooldown. If you, the first Roadhog that hooks, they're gonna get their first shot in, but the other Roadhog is gonna shoot you shortly afterwards. Then he's gonna cancel that, hook you, and then he's gonna get the second shot in slightly ahead of you because he's hooked you, and then you're gonna die from that second shot in most cases. So, try not to be the Roadhog that hooks first, because usually the Roadhog that hooks first is the one that dies, counterintuitively. They have a Winston over here. We do have to try and worry about the Pharah, but right now we're more concerned with trying to kill the tanks as well. So, you know, we come over here, we huff our paint. Small thing that really makes a big difference, actually. If you're in sight of the enemy team and you're huffing on your paint, turn around, because think about Roadhog's model, right? He's not built like a snowman. His head isn't on the top of his model. It's slightly set forward. So if you turn around, they can't actually score headshots on you very easily anymore. Instead of showing them your big bulbous head, show them your magnificent ass instead, and they will do less damage to you while you're trying to heal up. So we missed the Winston right there. That's unfortunate. We don't really want to move on to the point right now, because the point is, like, actually really dangerous for us to be standing on, because we don't, like, our hook is on cooldown, and our paint is on cooldown as well, so we're pretty vulnerable right now. We're also Roadhog. Roadhog is a very soft tank because, yeah, you've got 600 hit points, but none of it's armor. You don't have any shields. Your only way to regenerate HP is a long cooldown, and it's, like, pretty easy to kill Roadhog, especially when there's another Roadhog on the enemy team. So it's pretty risky for us to walk onto the point right now, having just missed our hook on the Winston. And now their Roadhog comes around here. He catches us with all of our cooldowns down, and we're basically screwed at that point. I mean, I get it, you're playing a tank, so you're like, I want to go and stand on the point because that's what I'm supposed to do. The thing is, Roadhog isn't a straight tank, right? He, like, I always say this to people, Roadhog isn't really a tank, he's more of a DPS that happens to have a lot of hit points. And then they go, well, of course he's a fucking tank, he's in the tank category. If you think about it, he's the only tank in the game that can't build the damage block stat, so he's not very good at protecting people. Roadhog's whole thing as a tank is that he's very threatening. He can kill someone who is inside of his line of sight from very far away. 21 meters, I think, is the exact range of his hook. Very far. He can just one-shot you, or two-shot you if you're like a tank. His whole kit is based around killing people. He doesn't really tank by absorbing damage for people. He tanks by zoning people and being very threatening. Because if you're in Roadhog's line of sight, there's the possibility you die if there's nothing in front of you, right? So, you have to be careful about going forward to stand on objectives, because if it's just you and, like, all your cooldowns are down, it can be very easy for them to actually just kill you. Because Roadhog is not as threatening once his hook is on cooldown. Like, when you see a Roadhog use his hook, you're like, oh, thank goodness, that's 7 seconds where he can't really kill me now. I mean, he can, but it's much, much harder at that point. But anyway, we died. Our team has still managed to win the fight and gotten control of the point, so that's great. And we're going to come and stand up here now. Going a little bit far forward, especially since at this point the other team, like, we've seen them with a Roadhog, so it's pretty scary to just walk up that far when we don't know what we're going to find around the corner. We find the whole enemy team, we start trying to huff our paint really close to them, and we just get flashbanged and killed. And their Roadhog comes around as well, and, like, we get bursted to death, basically. So, not great. You gotta be careful about going up too far as Roadhog as well, because if you overextend as Roadhog, you usually die, because there's not many ways you get out, right? Like, your team has to help you get out if you overextend, because Roadhog himself, very easy to kill, surprisingly squishy, no mobility. You've gotta be careful about overextending. We go just, like, a little bit too far up. It's alright to, like, stand at, like, the top of the ramp, but you basically don't wanna go past the block at the top, because then you're getting, like, really close to the enemy spawn at that point. And since, as well, we know the whole team got wiped and they're going to come back at roughly the same time, really risky to poke your face out that far. So we're back now, though. Nothing really came of it, so it's, you know, don't get punished, don't have to learn. We've almost got whole hog built up again. We're getting a little, we can stand up here, but we don't really want to go past these bricks right here. Like, right here, this is pretty risky to go that far up. Their Roadhog's hook was on cooldown, though, so we don't get punished for it. However, their McCree has now popped out in front of us. Our hook's on cooldown. We're in a pretty bad spot right here. So, because he's used his flashbang, right, he can't stop us from using Take a Breather anymore. And it's going to be pretty fucking hard for us to kill this McCree, because our hook is currently on cooldown, and he's got Sound Barrier HP on him as well. So, he's also just used Fan the Hammer, so he has to reload right now. If you start huffing your paint and turn around, you would probably survive long enough for your hook to come off cooldown, and then maybe you can turn around, hook him, and kill him. Instead, we don't do that. He just reloads, shoots us, comes up here, and starts using High Noon. I think he kills someone with it. Yes, he killed Lucio with it. I wouldn't really expect you to survive still, but, you know, if you can survive long enough by taking the breather and then you manage to just hook him quickly enough, you could probably kill him as well. It would certainly be a better chance than what we actually did right there. If the enemy team has run out of CC, then you can, and you're really low HP, you can try and take a breather and maybe survive through it, because, you know, at that point we're like one shot away. McCree has only got to shoot us somewhere and we're gonna die, but we need to shoot him a couple of times because of his HP, and our hook was on cooldown, so slightly better, like, you know, like a 10% chance is better than, like, no chance, right? So we come up here, we hook their Reaper, but then we get hooked by their Roadhog, so we don't get to kill him. I get turned away when you're doing this. Whole Hog can actually headshot you as well, so, you know, we get out of it with full HP anyway, but turn away when that kind of thing is happening. We've got their Winston jumping around in front of us. We reload, we kill him. That Winston's basically committing suicide, so it's pretty free. We've managed to build up Whole Hog. We're just going to come into the point and use it. Don't really recommend doing that because of the way Whole Hog is. Whole Hog as an ultimate is really awkward. Like, it's one of the worst ultimates in the game. It's not the worst ultimate in the game, but it's certainly, like, pretty low down, in terms of usefulness. Basically, you wanna, like, just rushing onto the point and using it like that is gonna tend to not get very much done, especially since, like, King of the Hill, people tend to be pretty spread out. The best use for Whole Hog generally is you use it to stop the enemy team's aggression. You hear, like, Lucio drop the beat and they start rushing in and you're just like, no, I'd prefer you didn't do that. Or, like, Anna nano boost somebody and you're like, no, I'd rather you don't do that. Whole Hog, you basically get to tell the enemy team, no, you're not actually going to engage right now. You're going to engage, like, 4 seconds from now instead if you still want to. Very hard to be aggressive with it because of the fact it pushes people away. If you can pin somebody into a corner, then yeah, like, sometimes you'll come into, like, Sanctum and you'll be able to, like, pin everybody in the back room and just fucking grind them to death. But map like Ruins, it's really hard for us to pin anywhere and pin somebody somewhere and kill them. You're usually just gonna, like, push them away, which, I mean, can be helpful, but that's not really a great use for it. I would have just saved it to try and like hold. Basically, like, I wouldn't expect it to get very much done, so I wouldn't use it right here. And in fact, Genji gets most of the work done with his Dragon Blade. And everything we did right here with Whole Hog, we could have done without Whole Hog, because, and I mean, I guess that's like kind of a hindsight is 2020 thing at the same time. But like, we come on to the point, we only see like one person here, so, you know, it's whatever. Reaper drops behind us and starts using Death Blossom, and we kill him with the Whole Hog. But if we weren't using Whole Hog, we could just hook him, cancel the Death Blossom, and then shoot him in the face and kill him instead. And then, like this, we aren't even using it anymore, right? So, everything we did there we could have done without Whole Hog, and I wouldn't expect Whole Hog to get very much done right there, so. Bit of an overcommittal of resources. It would be much better to have right now, because the enemy team doesn't actually have much time left, so we could use it to, like, stall out their last push, or, like, really, like, stop their aggression as they're coming in. It's hard to be aggressive with Whole Hog, unless you're in specific circumstances. So, anyway, though, there Winston is trying to come in right now. He's come in with Primal Rage. We hook him, we have to reload. Not really much point hooking him right there, if I'm to nitpick, because the hooking Winston during Primal Rage, basically you're doing that to stop him hitting somebody else. He's already hitting us at that point, so we don't really need to hook him. But then, you know, everybody gets pushed around, we get dropped right in front of two shotgun enemies, and we just get fucking killed. As you would expect to happen when there's a Roadhog and a Reaper in your face. So, you know. See, that's where having Whole Hog would have been a lot more useful, because we could just be like, no, Winston, I'd rather you actually just stay over there for a little while instead. But we have almost built up Whole Hog again. We have just gotten it right now. We don't have Dragon Blade and Nano Boost like we did last time, so it's going to be harder for us to take the point this time round. But we managed to get the drop on there, Winston, and just fucking kill him, so that's great. We've killed their main tank right at the start. We're coming in with Whole Hog. We get Nano Boosted partway through. Again, we don't really get very much done with Whole Hog at that point. Still wouldn't really expect it to, but I also think I would have probably done the same thing at that point, because we end up using Dragon Blade and Nano Boost anyway. But going into this, basically, when I was watching this the first time, I was like, oh, we only have Whole Hog, so I guess this is pretty much the best you can do with it. We ended up not really doing anything with it still, but we still ended up just, like, getting through them, because they had lost their main tank right at the start of the fight. Genji came in with Dragon Blade as well. You know, we were distracting, if nothing else, with the Whole Hog. So it's all fine. Now we're on Well. Good mount to play Roadhog on. We can dump people in the hole. Easier to use Whole Hog on this map, because you can push people into the hole, there's better walls to try and pin people in with Whole Hog, so this is a better map for Roadhog overall than Ruins, but also, Roadhog is the type of hero that's never bad, because when you can one-shot somebody from 21 meters away, that's pretty fucking strong. I remember when the game came out, everyone was like, man, Roadhog's a pretty bad hero, all he does is feed alt charge, and like, oh, whatever. But then, and like, this was the period in time McCree was really overpowered, because Fan the Hammer did a stupid amount of damage, and then eventually everyone just sort of realized, you know, Roadhog basically does the same thing, but from 21 meters away, and he doesn't have to overextend himself, like, he doesn't have to extend himself to do it. And then we slowly realized, damn, Roadhog's actually really fucking strong, isn't he? You know, so, it's funny how our opinions on the game can change over time. And now we've come to realize Roadhog is a hero that's never really bad, right? So, we missed the hook on the other Roadhog right there. That's unfortunate. That would have been a pretty sick pick to get right there, but whatever, it happens. They pick off our Reaper, but our Winston's just killed their McCree, so we've basically traded one for one. Try to dump the Roadhog in the hole. We were just a little bit too far away, but he obligingly just walked backwards off the edge anyway, so it's all good. Reaper pops out right in front of us, very scary. Especially since we... Was our hook on cooldown right there still? Yeah, it was, wasn't it? Again, look away, usually, when you're doing that. Yeah, our hook was off cooldown, so pretty much... On cooldown, rather. So pretty much the best thing you can do when a Reaper is right in your face is try and kill the Reaper before he can kill you. But that's very scary when you're playing Roadhog to find a Reaper right in your face and you don't have your hook. Because... Common misconception, people are like, Reaper counters Roadhog. Well, Sometimes. Reaper is a stupid hero. Reaper only counters Roadhog if Roadhog's hook is on cooldown, because Roadhog can just one-shot Reaper. So it's hard to counter somebody when that person can just one-shot you from 21 meters away, you know? It's hard to counter that person. Honestly, like, the best, like, kind of the best person you can really pick against Roadhog reliably is Soldier, because Soldier can just, like, hit his fucking massive bulbous head from outside of his range and charge tack visor off Roadhog all day. Reaper does not really counter Roadhog. So, there Roadhog's over here, he's putting himself in a bad position. We could go in more aggressively in this position because of what we see Roadhog doing. Because we see Roadhog actually starts taking a breather over here, and we, like, hesitate to go in. We could just walk up to him and, like, get a shot in him while he's doing that. And our team is pretty close to us right now. We end up coming up a lot closer right here, and then, but we've already got one shot in. He hooks us. He's not gonna kill us. So what I would have done right here is we use two shots over here. Those two shots didn't do anything because we could see basically none of Roadhog. And ammo conservation is pretty important for Roadhog because his gun is very strong, but it only holds four shots. So you have to be careful about, like, using your ammo. So I would not have used those two shots right there. As soon as I see him take a breather, I'm just going to walk up to him and, like, left click into his face while he's taking a breather. And then even if he hooks me, it doesn't matter because I'm full HP and I've gotten the first shot in. So he should still die regardless. And our team is also close to us anyway. The scary thing about doing that would be that we put ourselves near an edge, so it wouldn't be too hard for us to get bumped off the edge, but we end up doing that anyway, so it obviously wouldn't have mattered. But that's also kind of a hindsight is 2020 thing. So we use Whole Hog right here. I would have used Whole Hog for this exact same reason. And we just completely, like, make sure we get control of, like, we kill their push, we push them away. It's all fine. I would have done the exact same thing. We killed two people, broke Reinhardt's barrier, all that good stuff. This Reinhardt is overextending a lot right now. Like, he should die for that, honestly, because his team isn't here to support him while he's doing this. As soon as we see the Reinhardt shield break, basically, we should be trying to hook him. Because we should just hook him right there. As soon as you see a Reinhardt shield starting to crack when you're playing Roadhog, you want to try and estimate how long it's going to take for it to break, and then the idea is you try and hook somebody in as it breaks. In that case, you would hook the Reinhardt in, and he would probably have died if we hooked him immediately. But he ends up getting away, but he got away with it, came back in, and now we're going to kill him in the end. Anyway, Genji's also off over there using Dragonblade. They've got a Pharah right here. Oh, I managed to kill their Pharah, though. Absolutely textbook, just hooked her, killed her. Great, awesome. So now the enemy team has to regroup. It's okay to stand up here, but you do have to be careful. Like, you do have to bear in mind the enemy's team comp when you're standing up here, because when you're standing this close, like, when you're standing up here, like, this is fine to stand up here, but we are very close to the hole. So the fear is you're standing up here, the enemy team starts advancing in, and Lucio just, like, slips in and pushes you into the well. Or Pharah just, like, is above us and pushes us into the well. So, because our options to retreat are kind of limited, because we either go into the room on the left behind us, or we back up onto the point, but we have to back up right next to the hole. So if the enemy team is kind of, like, if they have, like, a Lucio or a Pharah up here, it can be very easy for them to push us in the hole as well. So you have to be careful about that if you're going to stand this far up. You can stand this far up, it's fine. Like, this isn't really overextending. You're still basically on the point. It's hard for them, like, they have to funnel down this narrow alleyway. I'm sure we've all seen at least one game where we've been playing on well and you can't get out of the fucking alleyway at the start because you've just lost too much momentum. So their Roadhog comes in right there, and the thing that we fear happens, their Lucio just pops out. We don't even know he's coming at this point, so there's not really much we can do about it. Like, he pushes us off before we can even actually see him because he's behind the Reinhardt. But that is the fear. You do have to be careful when you're standing that close to the hole and the enemy team is gonna, like, come in at you. In that case, though, yeah, we didn't even know that Lucio was coming, so I guess the argument would be, because we know they have a Lucio, we shouldn't stand there because that might happen to us. But, like, you know, I'm not gonna... It doesn't matter overly so in the grand scheme of things. So we get back things are not really going well for the enemy team. Regardless, we start just trying to push people away from the point because we're about to win. They managed to still get on the point, so feels bad, man. But, you know, we're basically going to win this round. We just have to go through the ceremony of killing everybody that's coming in to touch it. As you can see, by the timer left on this game, we don't win this game 3-0. We do still win this game, though, spoiler warning. So now we're on Lighthouse. Lighthouse, decent map for Roadhog. Probably the easiest map on Ilios to really use Whole Hog on, because there's a lot of places you can pin people with it, and you can push people off ledges with it. And it's just always good at stopping aggression regardless of the map, so. We miss our hook right there, that's unfortunate. Again, turn away when you're doing this. You don't really want to just, like, look at the enemy team when you're taking a breather. So we come in right here, we get hooked, we kill him though, because our team's here to back us up with it. And now, we could go in more aggressively on this Reinhardt right here. It's hard for Reinhardt to really stop a Roadhog, because he just doesn't do enough damage. Like, we could really just start, like, pushing in as soon as we see him coming this way. But he charges off over in this direction anyway. And, you know, he's fucking dead. Like, he shouldn't charge in at that point, because he's fucking dead. And now, our team's driving him off. We didn't really even have to do anything this round, because our team just killed a bunch of people without really much contest. So, you know, it always feels good when you don't really have to do anything to win the round or get control of the point. We could go in more aggressively on this Reinhardt, because the enemy team is going to take a little bit longer to regroup, basically. Like, they're not all up here, it's just Reinhardt and Lucio right now. We missed the hook again, which is unfortunate. Now the enemy team is starting to group up, and our team is going really far up at this point. Anna gets pinned, and we miss the hook, so we don't save her. Feels bad, man. I mean, ideally we hook her, obviously, but, you know, if we miss, you know, it happens. So, enemy team's coming in right now. We tried to hook the Reinhog. Ooh, wouldn't that be a scary hero? But we end up hooking the Lucio instead. And we end up getting killed by them. We don't kill the Lucio. Feels bad, man. But we lost our Anna right at the start of the fight to Reinhardt's pin, so it was going to be difficult for us to win that fight anyway. If you lose, like, a tank or a healer right at the start of the fight, it tends to be really hard to win that fight. Unless you have, like, a bunch of ultimates still. We're regrouping right now. Genji's just died, like, a really staggered death, so ideally we'd be waiting for Genji to regroup with us, but our team is still kind of trying to go in right now. Unfortunately, their Roadhog got put to sleep, but the Reinhardt came over here to protect him. This is a pretty minor thing in the grand scheme of things, but if someone gets put to sleep and you can't just, like, hook them, you want the person to stay asleep for as long as possible, basically. Because that's just, like, if they're asleep for 6 seconds, then that's better than them being asleep for 3 seconds, because that's 3 extra seconds they're not doing anything in the game. So I wouldn't shoot at them right here, because I would prefer if the Roadhog stayed asleep for slightly longer, and we end up shooting him in the foot and waking him up a little bit sooner. But that's, like, a very nitpicky thing that is unlikely to make a difference, but it can make a difference. So Roadhog's using his Whole Hog right here. Our hook was off on cooldown, so we couldn't stop him immediately, but he was made to be purple, and then we hooked him in and we killed him. We get Take a Breather off of that Whole Hog, so that's a really good time to use Whole Hog, to use Take a Breather, and we push their Reinhardt off the edge before he can Earth Shatter us. So now we just walk at them, because we've killed both of their tanks. There's nothing they can do to stop us at this point. We're turning over here to try and kill the Mercy. The Mercy's getting away from us. The thing is, I wouldn't really go after this Mercy, because the likelihood of you killing her in a timely manner is pretty unlikely. Your hook is on cooldown right now, and she's about to disappear around this corner. There's no way you kill this Mercy quickly anymore, because your hook is on cooldown. It would honestly be better if you just go onto the point and start fighting people over there, because, like, look at all the time we spend chasing after this Mercy. That's time we spend doing nothing. And, like, they're still winning the fight over there. Like, Genji's using Dragon Blade and killing people, so it's not like it's gonna matter a huge amount in this circumstance, but you're not gonna kill the Mercy in a timely fashion. You'd be better off just being on the point trying to get control of that, rather than spending time chasing someone you're not gonna kill. And you can also always try and hook her as she's coming in to res people as well. But she came in, she res people, their team had mostly regrouped by that point as well. They sound barrier, they kill us, feels bad, man. We've already used some of our ultimates, so this is not going to go well. If we draw our attention to the kill feed, we see Genji has just killed Mercy with Helix Rocket, so Mercy's really fucking tilted right now. Ooh, she's yelling at that soldier. But we're still going to lose control of the point because, like, you know, a bunch of people are dead over there right now. And more people are dying. Winston killed somebody with Primal Rage, but then killed himself, so someone overestimated their jumps a little bit. Or underestimated it, I guess. So, we're regrouping now. We do still have some ultimates. Genji's managed to build up another Dragon Blade remarkably quickly, and Reaper has Death Blossom. Death Blossom's not exactly a fantastic ultimate, but, you know, it is an ultimate. Genji's just managed to pick off Lucio right at the start of this fight, so that's really good for us. And their Reinhardt is currently purple, so we're just trying to get in on him as quickly as possible, and he's been made to be not alive anymore. Roadhog's coming out right here. We should hook the Roadhog in that circumstance. We could have hooked him a lot sooner, because as soon as we see he's at half hit points, it's now okay, like, it's now okay for you to hook this Roadhog first, because you'll kill him off the first shot. Or if not, like, your team are, like, right behind you, they'll certainly help you kill him, if nothing else. But as soon as you see a Roadhog is, like, half HP, you can now hook him first, because you'll kill him. So we're chasing after their Mercy right now. We missed the hook on this Lucio. Mercy's dead over there. Attack Visor is happening over here. It's unfortunate we didn't have our hook to try and kill him faster. Feels bad, man. I would also use this whole hog, but unfortunately, Genji starts deflecting. We get Earth Shattered, so we don't really get to do too much with it. I would have done the exact same thing, and the exact same thing would have happened to me as well. So it's just, you know, sometimes the best play you can make is not going to work. Sometimes your best is just not good enough. We don't need to use Take a Breather right here because we are at basic, we start taking a breather at full HP, in fact. So we're not really paying close attention to how much HP we had right there. We didn't need to use Take a Breather. Take a Breather is a pretty important cooldown. Has a long cooldown. Don't want to use it too frivolously. There, Genji's using Dragon Blade right now. We missed the hook on him. Not unsurprising, it's hard to hook a Genji, especially when he's dashing around with Dragon Blade. Then we get pinned in the corner with Whole Hog and we die. It happens, basically. There's not much you can do in that position except still have Whole Hog, but I can't imagine anybody having been in that position still holding Whole Hog, so it happens. Sometimes shit happens. It's possible to make no mistakes and still lose, which is something that's worth bearing in mind when you play a competitive game, because people get really tilted about, like, losing games. Statistically speaking, you're gonna lose, like, half of the games you play, and there's not really anything you can do about it. It is possible to make no mistakes and still lose. So they have a Tracer now, which is, like, you know, it's an issue. I personally find Tracer easier to hook than Genji, because of the way Tracer players tend to be. Because here's how Tracer players are supposed to act, right? There's a rhythm to playing Tracer where it takes her a second to shoot her gun, to empty her clip, and it takes her roughly a second to reload. So the idea is when you're playing Tracer, you shoot for a second, and then you blink while you're reloading, because you're doing something while you're reloading. You're keeping mobile, being harder to hit, you know? Because you obviously can't be doing damage, so you blink while you're reloading to be doing something during that downtime. So if you watch a Tracer and you see her start reloading, that means she's going to blink. She's probably not going to blink a second time right afterwards. So if you watch for her reloading and then just watch where she blinks, you can probably hook her after that point because she's going to start trying to do the second of shooting. So I personally find it quite easy to hook a Tracer because of that. But that's mostly a personal preference thing. A lot of people say Genji's easier to hook because you can, if he starts deflecting at you, you can just sort of, like, count how long it's going to take for him to stop deflecting and then hook him right as it ends. I find that harder than hooking Tracer, personally, but whatever. So we've come up right here, and we've gotten a hook on Roadhog. Unfortunately, we had to reload after getting the one shot in, so he manages to kill us. You do have to count your ammo pretty carefully when you're playing Roadhog, because the nightmare situation is you hook somebody, and then you have to reload, so you don't get to kill them. In that circumstance, we wanted to reload before we hooked them, or just, like, shoot him instead of hooking him, and then we could, like, CC him after we shoot him, and maybe our team kills him. But, you know, we hook him. Oh, God, we gotta reload. Feels bad, man. But as you can tell from the amount of time left on this game, this doesn't go for another two rounds. We win this round. We are going to play a little bit of D.Va during this round as well, so, you know, don't worry. The title isn't lying, but it's not exactly an even split. So we're back on Ruins right now. They have a Reinhardt and we don't have a Reinhardt, which is very unfortunate. If you see they have a Reinhardt and you don't have a Reinhardt, you should consider changing to Reinhardt, because the team that doesn't have a Reinhardt is usually the one that's at a disadvantage, because you can't block Earthshatter if you don't have a Reinhardt, basically is the issue. So it's really easy to advance into a Reinhardt and just get Earthshattered, and there's not terribly much you can do about that if you don't have a Reinhardt. So it's worth considering. Right here, we hooked him first. All things being equal, the Roadhog that hooks first is the one that dies. So, if you are gonna hook the Roadhog, try to get, or if you're gonna be the Roadhog that hooks first, either try to have him, like, try to see if he's half HP or close before them, or right-click him first, because the other way you win the Roadhog versus Roadhog matchup is you right-click, and it's, like, a decent shot into him with your right-click, and then you left-click, you hook, left-click, and you should kill him, because you can kill a Roadhog in two shots. But if you don't think you can do that, try not to be the Roadhog that hooks first, because that's, counterintuitively, that's the one that usually dies. Like, we look at their team right now, like, you know, we still got Winston. It's worth changing to Reinhardt, I think, in this position, because we don't have a Reinhardt. They do, and we're on Ruins, which is a King of the Hill map that Reinhardt is actually pretty good on. But, yeah, it doesn't matter overly so at the end of the day. King of the Hill, Reinhardt's still not a requirement on King of the Hill, basically. It's a little bit too much like Deathmatch for Reinhardt's taste. Reinhardt likes if the aggression is coming at him from one direction. He doesn't deal so well with aggression coming from multiple angles, which tends to happen on King of the Hill. Ruins is one of the better ones because it's basically just a straight line. There's not so many ways to get around people, but yeah, it's still a King of the Hill map at the end of the day. So we take a breather right here as we're at full HP being healed by a Mercy. I have to imagine that was an accident right there, though. So, we're coming over here. We try to hook the Roadhog again, and we accidentally hook the Lucio, but we don't manage to kill him. Oh, God, excuse me, which feels bad, man. So, we back up. We don't really need to take a breather right here either, because we're right next to both of our supports, so we could probably just let them heal us instead and save the cooldown. But right now, we've lost two people on our team, so we should be backing up, because this isn't going to work anymore. We're going in 4v6 right now. We managed to hook and kill this soldier, so that's great, but it's still pretty scary to be doing this. That's not a great time to use whole hog, because we're still down people at this point. Like, Reaper even just got killed right now, because he got hooked. And again, it's hard to use whole hog in an aggressive fashion like that, unless you're in a specific setup for it. And we end up just getting CC'd immediately, which, I mean, you know, is hard to predict happening, so I'm not going to really focus on that, but I still wouldn't expect Whole Hog to get too much done in that circumstance. Unless we know, like, Anna is going to... Oh, I said Nana. Fucking hell. Unless we know Anna is going to nano boost us, then maybe we can get something done with it, but I wouldn't have used it in that circumstance. So we've changed to D.Va now. D.Va's pretty good against their team comp, on paper, at least. D.Va tends to not be such a fantastic hero in most cases these days, because she's been made very squishy now. I don't know what the fuck Blizzard's up to with D.Va. Like, she doesn't have... I'm not gonna go into it right now, because that's, like, a long-winded argument. Let's not get into it right now. We're in an awkward position right now because we can't really get in on anybody that we want to be trying to bully around. So we're just over here trying to put some damage in on Reinhardt's shield. I wouldn't use my booster like that because it's a pretty frivolous use of your booster. You basically use it to get around the corner faster, which is not a great use of it. Now you don't have it to, like, get away for another 6 seconds, and if you find somebody out of position, it's going to be harder for you to punish them because the shift is on cooldown. And you could have just walked around that corner. Like, shifting around that corner saved you, like, half a second. It's just a bit of a frivolous use of a cooldown. And now what's going to happen is we're going to get hooked, and we're going to get Earth Shattered, and it's going to feel bad, and, you know, there's not much you can do about that other than dodge the hook, but I mean, you're playing D.Va, so that's going to be difficult as well, because you're pretty fucking big as D.Va. At least in mech, anyway. So, right here, we get hooked again. we position really aggressively at this point because we like press ourselves right up against May's wall. The thing is with D.Va, when you lose your mech and you're playing Zero Suit Samus, you are no longer a tank. I find there's an issue with D.Va players where they get taken out of their mech and they still keep trying to play as if they are still a tank. You're not a tank anymore. Now you're playing a ranged DPS, and the idea is you just sit far back and try to build up a mech. And here's how I try and tell people to think about it when they're playing D.Va, right? Where you're not playing D.Va when you're out of your mech, right? Because D.Va's based around her mech. So you can't shift. You're not a tank anymore. You've got 150 hit points. You do like more damage usually, but that's about all you've got going for you. You've got no other abilities. You're squishy, easy to kill. So basically when you lose your mech, you effectively die, right? Because you're no longer playing D.Va at that point. You're playing baby D.Va, who is much worse than regular D.Va. But if you can get another mech relatively quickly, like if you just like shoot into their tanks or like just shoot a few people over that period of time and get your mech back relatively quickly, you effectively respawn much quicker, because when you get back in your mech, that's you respawning as D.Va. But if you get taken out of your mech and then you run around for like 5, 10 seconds as baby D.Va and then die, what happens then is you have added 5 or 10 seconds to your respawn because you're dead when you lose your mech, right? So you just want to sit far back, a position much safer, and just try to build up another mech, because then you get to respawn and join the fight a lot quicker than if you die as baby D.Va. I mean, you know, sometimes that's not always going to be feasible, because sometimes you're going to lose your mech right in the middle of the enemy team, and then you pretty much just get fucked, right? So, you know, but ideally, you get another mech. So, but we get rezzed by Mercy, and we get nano-boosted as we're going in. Nano-boosted D.Va, actually pretty spooky, because it does a lot. Suddenly, she becomes quite hard to kill, and she's got infinite ammo automatic shotguns, so she starts doing a lot of damage. And we're able to just swing it back around off of the res. We kill a bunch of people while we're nano-boosted. Great, all good. We just rolled right over them. And we're half of the way towards self-destruct, so that's cool as well. Get it? Cool, because May's standing right there. Humor. So, we don't have very many ultimates right now, so that's a little bit spooky. All we've got is Death Blossom. But Death Blossom's not super scary to them, honestly, so it's going to be a little bit scary. We have gotten, like, a slightly worse ultimate, in my opinion. Like, self-destruct is, like, worse than Whole Hog, because you kind of use it for the same reason, but it's less likely to get much done. It's a lot like High Noon, where, yeah, it kills people, but it's really telegraphed and really slow, so it tends to be hard to get much value out of D.Va's ultimate. So, we are putting damage in on the Reinhardt right there. He gets right in our face, and we're like, we want to get away from him. We don't really need to, like, panic so much when Reinhardt's right up in our face, because we can kill Reinhardt as D.Va. Like, we've got a Mercy healing us, we're full HP, it's just Reinhardt coming at us at that point. We could actually just start shooting the Reinhardt, and rather than boostering away from him. And then, because we booster away from him, we aren't, like, in as good of a position to take advantage of the Blizzard, but that's also kind of a hindsight is 2020 thing, so, you know, whatever. But we didn't really need to booster away from the Reinhardt. But that's a pretty minor thing. As you can see, it ended up not mattering even a little bit. So, you know, whatever, right? So now we have self-destruct built up. We also have res and we have Death Blossom. D.Va's ult, hard to get value out of, very difficult to kill people with it. Usually it's just used for zoning. So that's what we should be expecting to use it for, basically just to like stop their aggression. May has managed to just make that Reinhardt like cry. Like, he's uninstalling the game as we speak, because he has just tried to Earth Shatter and it got blocked by May's wall, which is pretty much one of the worst things that can happen to you when you're playing Reinhardt. Oh my god, does it feel absolutely terrible. So that's great news for us. Reaper's also gotten behind them and killed two people with Death Blossom. We are bullying around their Reinhardt right now. We back away from him for a little bit. We could have just kept going the entire time, and then he gets rezzed the frame he dies. How about that? But whatever, we've still got, like, the advantage. We ult right there. Not a good time to use it, because the position we're in, very unlikely to kill people with it. And unlikely to do much zoning with it, and it in fact ends up getting put on the point, so it's even harder to zone people with it at that point. The idea is basically that you have to use it to zone people, because unless you're comboing it with another ultimate, D.Va's ultimate is extremely unlikely to kill people. Right there, like, its line of sight would get blocked by the pillars on either side. Reinhardt was nearby, so he could try and block it as well. And we're getting pushed away by Whole Hog, so it ends up getting just bumped onto the point anyway. I would have just held it in that position and tried to just hold my defense matrix over the Roadhog instead. So we end up not getting a super great use out of self-destruct, but honestly, self-destruct is an ultimate that's very hard to get value out of anyway, so I wouldn't feel too beat up about it either at the same time. We are bullying their Mercy around right now. Blizzard is happening again, so we're about to have a pretty sick time. And we just walk up and kill that man when he's got Discord on him as well. Lucio's going around over there, not much we can do to stop him. We come up, put defense matrix over McCree's face so he doesn't get to kill Mercy. Great, all good stuff. And, you know, they're rushing in to try and touch the point right now. We're going to kill that guy. Like, you can tell, we've won at this point. We just have to go through the ceremony of killing everybody that's coming up to contest the point. We're boosting after Boostio. We kill Boostio. We see Mercy's tether, and it looks like we spin around and try to find her, but she ends up, like, getting out of our line of sight, but she dies in the end. You know, we've won. You can tell we've won. We just have to kill everybody. There's a tracer here. It's annoying. None of us are great at killing tracer, so it's gonna take us a while. We just say fuck it. We use self-destruct. Whatever. So we win the game. And it was pretty easy overall. It took us a while. Like, even though this is only 4 rounds, it took us a while to get through the game. But, you know, it wasn't too terribly difficult, except for, like, the round we lost, obviously, but, yeah, you know, Lighthouse just wasn't our map, right? It's just what it was. So, you know, everything went pretty well. And look at that, that's actually a lot of eliminations. So there wasn't too terribly much that stood out to me, really, in this game. You know, there's a lot of minor things, really, like not turning away when you take a breather. We don't use Whole Hog fantastically. But at the same time, it's not surprising. Whole Hog is a hard ultimate to get value out of as well. Because it is, so there's a very counterintuitive ultimate to use in a lot of cases. We do position a little too aggressively at times when we're playing Roadhog. Like on Ruins, we go too far up and we get punished for it a couple times. But there's not really anything major, huge that stood out to me in this game. It was mostly mechanical things, as far as I saw. And in the email that you sent with this game, you also said that this was your first game as Roadhog, so that's not exactly surprising. But it was mostly mechanical things, honestly. Like, you know, we miss a few hooks. We're not turning away from people when we're looking at them. That's basically a mechanic thing. Mechanics thing. We don't land our shots as well as we could. Things like that. You know, stuff I can't really help you with because I can't tell you how to aim. I can tell you who to aim at, but I can't tell you how to aim. So, you know, like, it was a lot of little things, really. No massively huge mistakes. I think, if you just play Roadhog more often, you'd then just, like, build up your muscle memory, build up your mechanics, you'd be pretty good, you'd be really good at Roadhog, actually, because everything I saw was pretty much okay, barring mechanical issues. Like, we don't use Whole Hog fantastically in a lot of cases, but we already talked about that when that was happening, so I'm not gonna belabor it. But yeah, it was, like, mostly mechanical things, really, so I feel like if you just play Roadhog a little bit more, you'd be pretty good at Roadhog once you get, like, the mechanics down a little bit more, you know. I can't help you with that, that's all muscle memory, but that's pretty much all the biggest thing that stood out to me in this game was just, like, mechanic things. Roadhog is, like, a pretty simple to get hero to play, like, mentally, and the biggest mistake we make, like, meta side is just, like, overextending a few times, and not using Whole Hog very well. But other than that, it's basically just, like, minor mechanic things we already talked about. So, thank you very much for watching if you did. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. I'm more than happy to answer, and I hope you found the video helpful.